Welcome students to today's lesson. We are still continuing with types of materials, and today we want to explore more about free cutting steel, then nickel steel, then vanadium steel. So let's begin with the free cutting steel. So the important features of free cutting steel are their high machinability and high quality surface finish after finishing. These properties are due to high sulfur and phosphorus. Sulfur exists in the form of manganese sulfide, which forms inclusion in steel. These inclusions promote the formation of discontinuous chips and also reduce friction on the surface being machined, so produces good surface finish easily. While phosphorus is dissolved in the ferrite and increases hardness and brittleness. So the tool life achieved in machining free cutting steel is from 2 to 2.5 times higher than the carbon steel of the same carbon content. However, it must be noted that free cutting steel have lower dynamic strength characteristics and are more susceptible to corrosion. Free carbon steels are frequently supplied in the cold drawn or work-hardened form. These cold-drawn steels have high tensile strength and hardness but less ductile when compared to other kind of steels. So where has this material been used, or which kind of products has it been used to make? So this free cutting steel has been used in manufacturing of axles, bolts, screws, nuts, special duty shafts, connecting rods, small and medium forgings, cold upset wires and rods, solid turbine rotors, rotor and gear shaft, armature, keystock, forks and anchor bolts, screw stock, spring clips, tubing, pipes, light weight rails, concrete reinforcing, etc. So the next type of steel is nickel steel, and the percentage of nickel steel varies from 2 to 45 in steel. Steel having 2% nickel makes steel more suitable for rivets, boiler plates, bolts and gears, etc. Steel having nickel from 0.3 to 5% raises elastic limit and improves toughness. Steel containing nickel has very high tensile strength. Steel having 25% nickel makes it stainless and might be used for injection engines, turbine blades, etc. If nickel is present up to 27%, it makes the steel non-magnetic and non-corrodible. Inva is a nickel of 36%, and Super Inva is a nickel of 31%, are the popular materials for least coefficient of expansion and are used for measuring instruments, surveyor tapes, and clock pendulums. Steel having 45% nickel steel possesses extension equal to that of glass, a property very important in making links between the two materials, i.e. in electronic valves and bulbs. The next material is vanadium steel. Vanadium, when added even in small portion to an ordinary low carbon, increases significantly its elastic limit and fatigue resistance property. Vanadium makes steel strong and tough. When vanadium is added up to 0.25%, the elastic limit of the steel is raised by 50% and can resist high alternating stresses and severe shocks. So application, it is widely used for making tools. It can also be used for shafts, springs, gears, steering knuckles, and drop forged parts. So the last type of steel we discussed today is manganese steel. Manganese, when added in steel between 1 to 1.5%, make it stronger and tougher. Manganese between 1.5 to 5% in steel make it harder and more brittle, whereas that of 11 to 14% of manganese in steel with carbon percentage of 0.8 to 1.5% makes it very hard, tough, non-magnetic, and possesses considerably high tensile strength. Manganese steel may be forged easily, but it is difficult to machine, and hence it is usually ground. It is weldable, and for welding it, a nickel manganese welding rod is used. So where has it been used? Because of work hardening, it is suitable for jaws of stone and ore crushers, grinding plants, tramway and railway points, and crossings, etc. Manganese steel in the form of bar is now widely used for screening cork. It is also used for helmets and shields. It is used for agricultural implements such as shovels, etc. So this marks the end of our today's class. Let's meet again in the next lesson.